Yeah, hey everyone. So as we've talked about in the previous couple of topics, we've basically talked at a high level about Linux packages, just what the commands are, command lines, terminals, and whatnot. So today we're going to get a little deeper into that. Specifically, we're first going to start with this package concept we were talking about. So as we mentioned the other day, Linux uses packages instead of programs that you might typically be used to. So in Linux, like most operating systems, you have your hardware, so your CPU, your RAM, whatnot. You have your software, so that's app software, device drivers, and whatnot. And then you have your kernel. So your Linux kernel is basically your interface between the two. So basically, as I was mentioning, these packages are your software. So you have some software packages natively installed as a part of the Linux distribution, and others you have to install through something called a package manager. So that package manager, it really provides you those programs, applications for installation through some sort of command line, which is what we're using. So through a package manager, you can install, remove, update any sort of actions basically on these software packages from that software repository, which is basically the internet. So on my left, as we talked about, I have my Red Hat distribution. Red Hat uses something called Yum as its package manager. So one example that I want to run right here. So if I run a sudo yum upgrade, you'll see once you run it, if you're following along with a Red Hat instance, you'll have packages to upgrade. So yum out of the box automatically basically downloads any new package information from the internet, upgrades it, and then it's going to remove any obsolete or old packages from the system. As you can see here, I have nothing really to do with that. Great. So we're good with that. Notice how I use the word sudo right here. Your question might be, well, what is sudo? So if I run yum upgrade, look what happens. This command has to be run with a super user do sudo. It's administrator root privileges to perform certain tasks, because you don't want every user to be the root user on a system, because they can modify important config files and items of that sort. So with that sudo command, you get these elevated privileges for modifying specific files, packages, and whatnot with that. So on the right side of my screen, it's a little different. We're using Ubuntu, which uses apt, so this advanced packaging tool. So basically any sort of Debian distribution, so Ubuntu is an example, we'll use apt. Yum is usually just Red Hat. You may have heard of apt-get. I'm used to using apt because typically from what I've seen as a best practice, apt is supposed to be for a user and apt-get is supposed to be for the system. They perform the same package management tools, but apt is a little bit more user-friendly. It has like a status bar that tells you how like much longer you have and items of that sort. So like I said, apt is a little different than yum. So if I do a sudo apt update, it's a little different than what we're used to. So notice here, what it's doing is it's downloading package information from its sources. So specifically, you can look, it's the internet. Everything's up to date. Yum, as a different item, automatically downloads that package information once you run a command like this. So now that we have everything, we can run sudo apt upgrade, upgrade. UPG, awesome. Sorry about that. So there's nothing to upgrade, but basically what it's doing is it's actually installing those newly downloaded packages. Yum's a little more powerful because it does it in one command, but you kind of get the point with that. Once again, sudo, so sudo is Linux specific, not Linux flavor distribution specific kind of thing. All right, thank you everyone. Enjoy the rest of your day. Bye.